you've heard us talk about Vegas. You've heard us talk about the annual convention. If you're not plugged in, you haven't RSVP'd, you need to get that done ASAP. You're going to get to meet the likes of the Golden Goose, as we call him, Holden Hassell. He's going to be in attendance. Ben Bowman, Ryan Karras, who we call the Mouth from the South. You're going to get to meet Josh Jensen, Rita Alush, you name them, the top superstars, Lovely Johnson. They're going to be in attendance, and we'd love to see you there. Take the opportunity to invest in your business. Make this a great networking event as well as an educational session, and get in attendance. All you got to do is go to EFESroadshows.com, EFESroadshows.com, RSVP, book your seat, let's go. It costs nothing other than to get there. That's all it's going to cost you is to attend. No ticket to get in, none of that craziness. Just be in Vegas, March 21st, March 22nd. We hope to see you guys there. Last but not least, we want to get to Cole. I really don't want to delay any longer, but I'm going to throw the invite out there to each and every one of you guys. If you did not get signed up or you didn't even know about it because you weren't on the national call, if you'd like to participate in the Royal Neighbors of America EAP, they're doing a pilot right now. We've got about 18 people participating now. We've been given the okay to get more people to jump in and participate. If you'd like to do that, let me know. Give me a call, 800-765-0711. Hit extension 251 or call my cell phone, 972-339-0191. They're getting rid of the elite processes they had before. Most of you probably don't know about it, but the bottom line is they are finally coming out with an e-app, and it's a pretty sweet little process. So if you'd like to learn more, just let us know. Let's go ahead and get this kicked off so we can get Cole McCoy on.
The opinions expressed on this podcast are those of the speakers and presenters. They do not represent the opinions or views of the Equita Group, Equita Final Expense Services, or its affiliates.
We're sitting here with Cole McCoy. Normally, we got Ben Bowman as my partner in crime for the Insurance in Your Face podcast. We're also joined by Holden Hassell, who's here just kind of lingering, which we're always happy to have Holden here. If you don't know Holden, you should probably get to know Holden. He's got an award coming up at the event. Spends a lot of money on leads, but we're going to get to the message today.
Is that for best hair or most hair gel ball?
If we had that award, we would definitely give that to Holden, no doubt. I mean, Ryan talks about it all the time in the Builder Chat, but there's some truth to that. But no, it's actually, I'll just let the cat out of the bag. Holden knows already. Holden is getting the award for the most money spent on leads outside of his territory. It was something stupid. What was the number?
Probably like $12,000 or $15,000.
Yes. Outside of his territory, and it was like Tennessee. It was Georgia. It was
Maryland,
all over.
Right?
It's ridiculous. All of the horror stories that you think when you're like, I don't want to travel outside of my area. He did it, and he wrote a lot of business and made a lot of money. Also going to get him a top 10 award, I think, as well. So we're fired up to have Holden here with us. Chime in at any moment as well. We're going to talk today about pressing forward through tough times today. And who better to have than Cole, Holden, a couple of young guys in the business, young but long in the tooth when it comes to experience. And I'm excited about having them on because I just can't think of anybody better who's going to give it to you straight, as we do on the Insurance in Your Face podcast. We want to talk about, you know, as Ben always talks about and mentions, it's fun to talk about the rainbows and sunshine. That's not what we're going to do here. We want to talk about being able to persevere, push forward, press forward, and lean in during those tough times. And we'll start off with initially just getting started is tough for a lot of people. Can't even put the money up because we're just afraid of – I mean, it's fun to talk about, easy for some people to talk about. We'll just kind of discuss even getting started. There's a lot of fear in that.
Yeah, for sure. That's an obstacle. I talk to a lot of agents, and it's, well, let's just see how much money I'm willing to spend on leads. And, you know, a lot of times it's, oh, let me hold up for a little bit or whatever. You know, my story is one of a lot of success initially and then a lot of failure. And I had gotten into final expense very, very broke. In fact, I didn't have any money. I took a loan out to buy my leads, and I just remember telling my wife that, you know, either this is going to work or it's not. And I had actually already filled out a profile on AT&T to submit my resume and application and all that. And I told my wife, I said, hey, this is either going to work or it's not. And so, but what I did, I took a $3,000 loan out to buy my first batch of leads. And you know, I was like, well, I'm either going to run out of money or I'm going to make some sales. And so what happened was it was interesting. The first 3 or 4 days I got leads, I didn't make any sales. I was getting beat up. You know, you hear the "I want to think about it." You hear the people that make an appointment and then shut you down at the door. You see the curtains move, knowing that somebody's there and they're not answering. And for whatever reason, was just running into every cliche you think of when someone gives you the excuses that it's not working. And I remember calling my upline at the time and saying, look, man, I can't buy my leads next week. You know, I'm pretty much out of money. I'm not really sure what to do. And so make a long story short, I went out the next day over that weekend, I wrote $6,000 in 2 days, just under 2 days in the field. And that changed the trajectory of my entire career. And so, yes, it was scary. Yes, it was overwhelming. But Chase, it was a story that I love to tell, because especially when you're talking to an agent about buying leads, you're talking to somebody, you know, the first thing that people need to know is we don't make any money on this stuff. We're not making money on leads. We're doing this for your own good. And the reason that we keep pushing leads, like you need leads, is because they do work, and we ask you to do this because we want you to be successful. And so we understand it's fearful. We understand it's something that's not easy to pull the trigger on, but it's for your own good, and you just have to be willing to take a leap and, you know, hope that you land easy. But again, we work in a commission business. There's nothing guaranteed, and that's why it's so scary.
Well, it's scary also because, like, for all of us who have had a job as a teenager or as a young guy, you guys are all super young. We're around the same age, but we weren't raised, and I know I wasn't, like, my dad owns a company, but I wasn't raised by him to think of investing my money back into my business. We're used to having a job where you go to work, they pay you. You don't spend money to enhance your experience or your business because it was somebody else's business.
Yep.
So that's alien to us. It's totally green to us. And that's where part of the anxiety comes from. At first, you're even like, is this a scam? I got to spend money? You're hiring me. Why do I have to spend money?
Yep.
They don't understand that it's an entrepreneurship type setup. You have to invest in your business. So that's definitely part of the fear, right?
Holden? Absolutely. Yeah, hands down. I mean, job for me is something that, and I learned this a long time ago. Someone told me that JOB stands for just over broke. And it was so true. I was just working a regular job, a normal job, and I was just making enough money just to get by. And I wasn't happy with my life. I wasn't happy with where I was or where I was going. And I made a major decision in my life that I'll do whatever it takes to be a successful entrepreneur. And that does come with an investment. You do have to invest in yourself in terms of acquiring new knowledge, new information, growing your mind intellectually, as well as investing in your business with from a financial aspect. You always want to be continuously growing and getting in front of new people, buying new leads just to get in front of those new individuals. It doesn't matter where you get leads from. If you listen to Ben's call this morning, he doesn't care. If we took away leads itself, it'd be a major loss leader that we hemorrhage cash on. We'd be a lot more profitable from a business perspective. But the leads are how you're going to get in front of people. And that's why I think it's so incredibly important to have the best quality lead and the best quality lead sources, hence why it took us so long to roll out the Facebook leads to the entire population to make sure, first off, this is a good quality lead source, it's sustainable, and we can fulfill an order on a daily and weekly basis for agents to become successful.
It's good stuff. And we'll kind of segue to kind of embracing the craziness. So if you are one of those that, you know, if you're on this call right now and you have achieved any level of success in the business, we're going to roll through memory lane here and probably pop up some memories in the Rolodex that may be kind of making you laugh, kind of make you smirk, or may bring back some PTSD here. But we want to talk about embracing the craziness of when you first got going. You made that really leap of faith to invest in your business, but Lord have mercy, after you made the investment, you're waiting for the leads to come back. You've got carriers issuing writing numbers. Cole, a little bit about the craziness of just getting started and how wild it is.
It's overwhelming. let's just be honest. Let's call it what it is.
Damn, you're paralyzed.
Yeah, it is. And you know, we've talked in the past, and that it comes up a lot of this thing called paralysis by analysis. It's not to beat you up. It's not to sit here and say that you're a weaker individual because you're going through that. But we do need to acknowledge that that's a thing, and we need to learn to overcome it. In fact, in the beginning, if you're not feeling a little bit overwhelmed and you're not in that place of, oh my goodness, there's so much here, you're probably not doing, or there's probably more. There's probably more that you can do. Let's just be honest. It is a learning curve, and there is a lot to retain. I mean, that's, you know, the only other income I can think that you could, that is even comparable to this industry is becoming a doctor, going to school for 8 or 10 years, or a lawyer where there's so much more. I mean, do you think that's overwhelming? Well, of course. I mean, if you want to make real money, you have to be willing to go through that craziness. And that's just part of the game. And luckily, we haven't completely thrown you into the fire. I mean, there are tools. There are things you can plug into. There are things where you can reach out and ask questions, and you can keep everything organized and whatever. But part of that's on you. It's just embrace that crazy feeling of, oh, my goodness, I don't know how I'm going to do this. I mean, some organizations call it boot camp. I mean, and there's a reason for that. If you actually dive in and give it everything you got, it's going to feel like boot camp. You're going to reach the end of your rope at times and feel like, I don't know if I can do this. That's a good thing.
It's almost kind of like 2-a-days for those that play football.
Yeah.
You're just like, this is the worst. Like, if you're a freshman going to 2-a-days, that if you, for all of you on the call, if you played football and you went to 2-a-days for the first time as a freshman, you probably thought you were going to die. Even if you were, you know, the stud muffin coming out of 8th grade and you thought you were bad to the bone, you got humbled up real quick going as a freshman because it was a whole different level of athletic prowess that was needed just to survive 2-a-days. It's the same thing, I think. I mean, there's a similarity there. Do you feel broken?
Yeah.
I've got all of this going on, and I've got all the kind of
the sexiness
of it kind of wears off a little bit. And then you get humbled up because it hits you right in the face.
Yeah.
I mean, you're a young man in the business, Holden. Both of you guys wrote a lot of business last year. And you got a bright, bright future in the business and more than just one aspect. What was your first impression of when you first got rolling?
Oh, man. So I failed out initially, and then I came back in. I'd rather talk about the time that I came back into the business full time. And it was something that I did. I decided I'm going to get a car payment. I'm going to sell the car that I owned outright in cash. I sold it for $10,000. I took $5,000 of that money to use to live off of. And I took the other $5,000 and I dropped mail with it. I had no idea what a fixed lead cost program was. I didn't know it existed. I didn't know much about contract levels. I didn't know much about the business. I didn't know much about training. I didn't even know Ben Bowman. I didn't know any of these individuals here. I wasn't even with EFES, but I came back in and I said to where I got my leads from, I said, just, you know, here's $5,000, drop mail for me. Let's do it. Let me just try and be successful. And I came back in and what I didn't realize that there was so much uncertainty and so much risk when you're dropping mail and you don't know what the return's going to be, that risk can create inconsistencies in your business, inconsistencies in your cash flow. If there's not enough leads coming in, there's not, like, I don't know what's coming in this week for leads. So I wasn't certain as to what was going to occur. So there was still a degree of risk, but I took everything I had and I put into the business and I just made it work. Whether it was going to work or not.
Didn't you pay off your, like, that, you paid in a short amount of time, you paid off a lot of crazy stuff, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I mean, I have a BMW. I paid off like $35,000 in debt that I had accumulated over last year. I did that. And I was able to go ahead and do that just by being disciplined to do with my financials.
And I think that's huge. So I think it's super important to look at things through the lens of, if you just keep pressing through, there is success on the other side. We can sit here and tell you how horrible it is getting started, and you may feel that way at times. It's always a good thing, though, to keep your eyes focused on what's ahead. You see people who have done it before you. Just follow their path. Let them blaze the trail and follow the path that we've created for you. But at the other end, if you're able to put up with all the adversity and the strain and the constantly feeling overwhelmed and making yourself uncomfortable and, you know, working 60, 70 hours a week sometimes just to get that first initial push going, there is success and there is fulfillment. my wife is quitting her job in May. And, you know, for me, that's the whole reason that I got into this thing, was to create an avenue for her to see her dreams accomplished. And, but so there is amazing things at the end, but you have to go through the mud. It has to be earned. It can't be handed to you because you won't appreciate it, and then it'll actually destroy you.
This business is really a true meritocracy. It's not,
yeah,
like Eric said on the call, I think it was on the national call at the beginning, where he was like, this isn't just because you're buds with this guy, you get moved up and you get the promotion. This is a meritocracy.
You eat what you kill.
Yeah, absolutely. Yep. And so we'll go to kind of phase three now of it, as, and they all kind of sound similar, but they're different phases. But, you know, phase three where you, and this will happen. So once again, we may spark some memory for somebody on the call that's there now, but you've got going, you made the investment, you took that leap of faith, you jumped in. Now you've embraced the craziness, kind of starting to settle down a little bit. You're kind of starting to get your feet underneath you. There are going to be days where the storms hit, and things can be going good, and then, bam, you just get punched right in the mouth. We talked about the business being peaks and valleys. How do we approach that fight-or-flight mentality when it comes to when you hit that valley and not the peak?
Well, you would hope that you respond. Ideally, you would hope that you respond in a way that that is beneficial for your long-term success. But if we're going to be honest, we don't always respond. We don't. And let's get real here. I mean, there are times where we just straight up drop the ball. I think the number one thing we can say, I think we can all agree with this with a resounding yes, is that when you're up against the wall, hopefully you've been able to save a little bit of money for when the poop hits the fan, to put it in less morbid terms. But unfortunately, that's not always the case. And so when you're up against the wall, I know for me, I literally just said, look, I'm literally going to run out of money, or I'm going to make some sales and I'm going to have some cash flow and I'm going to keep doing this thing. I mean, it had come to that point of it's literally a fulcrum, and, you know, or a teetering point. You know, I could have gone one way or the other. It was that close. And I still remember the sale that put it over the top. You know, I had faced so much adversity that weekend. I could have not gone out. I could have said, you know what, I'm done. This isn't working. You know, this isn't for me. I'm just going to give up on insurance. And, you know, it's like boom, sale, boom, sale, boom, sale, boom, sale. And sometimes that's how it is. Sometimes you have to keep grinding, and it's not till that last appointment of the day.
But it's also one of the benefits of having – if you were on your own and having to figure this out, you didn't have, you know, you didn't have a Ben. You didn't have a mentor.
Yeah.
That even makes it even more of a daunting task when you don't have those people that you can confide in and say, or even more importantly, that have been through it and can say, Cole, I don't know what I'm doing here. Hold on, I don't know what I'm doing here. Yep. You guys are able to say, great, hey, I've been there. Here's what you need to do moving forward. It can be a daunting
task.
And it's
never ending, too. I think it's important to mention, like, look, you know, I decided to build an agency this year, and I won't get into the nitty-gritty of it, but I've had a lot of setbacks this year. Just being transparent with you all, it wasn't sunshine and daisies and rainbow colored unicorns. I mean, it's been a grind, you know, just being transparent. I lost some very valuable people. You know, I literally sat in a dentist's office and had three different surgeries, and, you know, my business is my mouth. Lost that ability for a little while. I think, Chase, you know what that's like.
Absolutely.
Holden, you'd probably die if you lost that.
Yeah, no, I got to talk, man.
But, you know, and so, you know, it still happens where I have to ask myself, what are you made of? What are you willing to go through to accomplish what you want? Some days it feels really good to say, okay, I'm just going to grind through this. Some days it's miserable. And you have to be willing to say that, but luckily, like Chase was saying, surround yourself with good people that can pull you out of the pit at times. Surround yourself with positive influence, whether that's your religion or spirituality, whether that's motivation, whether that's, you know, something that inspires you, like, you know, maybe you're really into working out or whatever. Find those positive things to keep you up and going, because you're going to need that support system at times to just carry you through when sometimes you haven't been able to. And that's so, so important. I mean, you hear Ben talk and he is one of the best of the best. Let's just call it what it is. It wasn't always easy for him, you know. And I think he tells a lot of stories of, almost not having enough money to provide Christmas one year. And we all go through those phases. So we're not here sitting here just talking at you saying, like, look, this is something that we've all gone through. I guess is what I'm trying to get to. And Chase, I'm holding you up.
Absolutely. I mean, hands down, I think it's something that I was taught this once by a professor at a university, is your past experiences mold you become in the future. And it's such a simple saying, such a simple phrase, but it's so incredibly true. And you have to go through those tough experiences in order to become a better, stronger individual, in order to become more successful in this business. And it's amazing what a simple phone call to a top producer or to an individual that you can relate with or your mentor can do to your entire day. You start off at 8, 9 a.m. and you're out there in the field, and your first three houses, you got into two or three houses, and it's 9:30, 10 o'clock in the morning. You already sat down in a couple houses, but you haven't gotten any sales. You're like, dang, this is a tough way to start the day. But you have to keep pushing through that. Because I've had days when I went out there and I've made $3,000 or $4,000 before noon, right? But I keep going until 5, 6 o'clock, and I make absolutely nothing. Or maybe add another $3,000. But you have to go through it because you never know when you're going to get that next sale. Yeah. And I always say that $100 app is always right around the corner, baby, and that's the difference maker. That's what's going to put you over the edge. So for me, I just look at it from the perspective of how many more people can I see when I'm generating more revenue, how much more time of day can I have, and how do I use the tools that are available to us in order to see more people? How do I stop writing paper applications and start writing e-applications to see another one or two people per day and think about what that does to your bottom line?
Well, you just hit on something that I think is kind of segues directly into our last point on this. We got to get uncomfortable, put pride aside, and we got to be willing to make that phone call. So often, I've seen in 12 years, 13 years of doing this, you guys can testify to this as well. I've seen so many guys fail in the business just because they weren't willing to pick the phone up and say, I'm struggling. I need help. Give me a call. Let's talk. These are my problems. What are my deficiencies? Diagnose the problem.
Yeah. One of my favorite quotes, and I'll probably butcher this, but there's a guy named Jordan Peterson. He's a psychologist, and he does a lot of great work. But he says it's adversity that unlocks our DNA, that we were created, that the way we were created, that adversity actually brings the best out of us. It confronts the things in us that are afraid to change or unwilling to change. But the problem is, and y'all probably agree with me, is that we're just not willing to go to that place where we're faced with that adversity that forces us to get creative, forces us to learn something new. It forces us to evolve. Yeah. And we'll never know our true potential until we go through that place of adversity. And that is so huge, whether you're talking about, transitioning from paper apps to e-apps, whether you're talking about, door knocking instead of calling and setting appointments if you can't get people on the phone, or, maybe you're transitioning because you're trying to sell a different product. You heard this final expense thing or this Medicare thing or whatever. People are successful. If you're not willing to confront that within yourself, that's where it has to start, and it's that adversity that completely unlocks your true potential. And we can all speak to that, I'm sure.
Yeah. Our whole business, I mean, if we're real about it, the houses we go into, the way we go about contacting somebody, uncomfortable is the word that surrounds that a lot of times. So, I mean, Holden, you can speak on this better than anybody. Door knocking, learning how to appointment set, vice versa, how to speak a certain way in front of a client.
Absolutely.
You've got to embrace that.
Yeah, no, I completely agree with that. I mean, it makes a lot of sense logically, too. The most important thing that I took away from yesterday, sitting down with Brian Jones, who's written $61,000 in the past, 65 days or so, is just unbelievable to see it. What I learned from yesterday is he was like, I am willing to admit that I don't know something, and I'm willing to ask for help. And I think that's a huge thing. And I was like, you know what? You're right. And a lot of it takes a lot of pride to say, listen, I don't know this. I'm not good at it. And I'm willing to ask you to help me to get better.
Is that right? That right there. I hate to interrupt, but I want to meeting Brian kind of blew my mind, because 30 plus thousand in a month, the month prior, 21,000, you think he's going to come in, beat his chest, say how great he is, but he's like,
he's here to learn. You made it. I'm in for 5 minutes. Yeah. I'm like, I will. Yeah.
I don't know everything. I'm here.
Shout out to Brian Jones
to learn. I don't know. So
if y'all hear Brian Jones on the podcast, just save it, download it, type it in the manuscript so you can go back and take notes on what. I mean, it's. That dude is legit.
Because he's new.
But he'll also never tell you that he is. He's always willing to learn. If you can take that, oh, my goodness. If you can take that mentality.
He's got the winner's mentality, just like you were talking about. Still new to the business, and he said that on Monday's national call. Still new to the business, doesn't know everything, still learning, links up with Josh, links up with Ben, and he dives in. But he goes, that's a great point you brought him up, that he is the prime example of that.
Yeah, and he's committed. He took out his phone and he showed me a picture of his goals. And he said, this is what my goals are. I have a 2-year plan and this is how I'm going to achieve it. I spoke with my wife. I sat down. We had this conversation and I'm going to get it done. And that's someone that's willing to take the initiative and do whatever it's going to take in order to be successful in this business. Because people that have failed know what it's like to fail, and no one likes that feeling at all. So when you sit around these people, these top producers, these highly successful business owners, and you are around them, you realize that, hey, you know what? If they can do what they're doing and they've been through this path and it took them 5 or 6 years, but they can expedite my path to success because they've got this training, they've got this platform that, hey, maybe what it took them 6 years to do, I can do in 1 year or in 6 months. That's an amazing thing, and it's really great to be a part of the organization that we're a part of, and I'm just grateful to be here myself. I really am. So really great stuff.
I am grateful and appreciative that you guys joined me today. I know we got a busy schedule over the next few days here. So I'm going to say thank you again. 200K producers, both of them in the room, jumped on with us today. Thanks, guys, for jumping on, and we'll have to do this again soon.
Yeah, absolutely. For sure.
Thank you guys for listening.
And if you're out there in podcast land right now, we've mentioned this before, and we've actually had quite a few take us up on the offer. If you don't have mentorship, if you don't have that person to call, if you don't feel like you have the lead, you don't have the platform, call us, 800-765-0711. Once again, 800-765-0711. Let us know. Just go to EFESonline.com, EFESonline.com. You're going to see Ryan pop up. He's going to want to chat with you. Strike up that conversation. It could be the difference between succeeding and failing. Having that person in the Northeast that you can work with, having that person here in Texas you can work with, we've got some of the best in the business all around the country. So whether it's about Medicare, whether it's about whether it's about final expense, whether it's about term, whatever it is, we got you. Just make that phone call. We would love to talk to you. And we want to see you in Vegas also. If you're not even with us, go to EFESonline.com, or I'm sorry, EFESroadshows.com, RSVP. That may be a great opportunity to interview us, see what we're about, and also get a heck of an event that's going to help you become a little bit more prepared to go out there and do what you want to do. So, boys, appreciate you again. Unbelievable. And we'll do it again soon.
The moderator has left the conference. The conference is now completed. Goodbye.